One of those lawmakers, Republican Senator Lindsey Graham of South Carolina. We saw you there with John McCain, Senator John McCain. Yeah. The president just said he believes a broad consensus exists on those points that he outlined. Do you?
I think the speech was a disaster. If his goal was to try to unite the Democratic Party and the hard left, maybe he succeeded. But I really do want to find a bipartisan solution to this problem. I thought the speech was combative. Bickering is not what's going on here. There's real serious policy debates. I'm by nature a guy that wants to solve hard problems, and there is no consensus about a $900 billion bill that is not going to be paid for, and the president's outline of how he would pay for this massive bill doesn't make sense to me. So, no, I think he lost an opportunity to create consensus and bring people together.
Well, that's what I wondered about when he used the phrase bickering. I mean, these are not small issues we're talking about. It's one-sixth of the American economy.
Well, and his explanation of the public option doesn't resonate with me. It's not credible. This idea that if the government gets into the health care business, it won't matter. It will matter dramatically. People will drop health care who are employers. Why would you pay for it if the government option is available to your employees? It would be a disaster. He has said many times before he got to be president he wanted universal health care. I want to work with Democrats. I'm on a bipartisan bill with Senator Wyden and Bennett to mandate coverage, but you do it through the private sector. It's revenue neutral. So I thought the president last night was unfair to critics. He accused every critic basically of being a demagogue, and he was going to call us all out. Well, quite frankly, that works both ways. Instead of calling each other out, we're trying to find common ground. And his problem is he can't sell this to the public. And if they do reconciliation where they try to jam it through with 51 votes, it's an admission that you can't get your own party on board because they got 60 votes in the Senate. And if we're going to do a demonstration project for medical malpractice, he can't embrace comprehensive reform there. Maybe we should do a demonstration project for health care reform rather than this massive bill.
Let me ask you about the you lie remark from Congressman Joe Wilson, Your fellow South Carolina Republican. Sure. He has apologized for that. The White House accepted it. Does that end the matter?
Well, I think he should have apologized it. I appreciate the White House accepting that apology. Joe Wilson is a good man. He should not be defined by that one moment. He has four boys who are all in the military. He's a good congressman. He's passionate about politics. The president of the United States, in my opinion, set the wrong tone in that meeting. It doesn't just that session. It doesn't justify what Congressman Wilson said. I'm glad he apologized, but I, quite frankly, was offended by the whole tone. I thought it was a partisan pep rally instead of a chance to bring the country together. And when it comes to Congressman Wilson's future, I will do everything I can to help him get reelected because he will support the president in Afghanistan if he sends more troops. Congressman Wilson's a good man who made a mistake. He apologized. But Democrats are not going to take that seat over. They're not going to send from that part of South Carolina someone to help President Obama with this massive agenda. So Joe Wilson's going to be just fine.
Sounds like the battle is about to go on anew. Senator Lindsey Graham, Republican of South Carolina. Thank you.